Hi, today we are going to see about what is open circuit, what is short circuit and circuit analysis, and we are going to see some more problem in detail using this open circuit and short circuit methods. First we will see what is open circuit. If a circuit is said to be open, which means it is not a closed one, it is having some disconnection in between some circuit. So just consider it is a one circuit which is not connected together, like consider this A and B terminal. This both are open, these terminals are open, so these circuits we are telling it as a open circuit. For open circuit we can see some calculations, how the current will be assumed and how the resistor will be taken and how the voltage will be taken and all. Since it is a open circuit, we cannot say there will be a current flow in the circuit because it is open. So there will not be any current flow in this circuit. So we are taking current is equal to zero. Hence we are deriving a resistance value from this current. So from Ohm's law, R is equal to V by I, just substitute this I value, then you will be getting infinity of the resistance. So anything by zero is infinity, which means we are just considering it as an infinite resistance. That's why the current is not flowing. According to the formula we are taking like this, but here there is no connection, so there will not be any conduction, so there will not be any flow of current in it. So if a circuit is said to be open, then the voltage across the open circuit terminal is known as open circuit voltage. So here the terminals A and B are open, so the voltage across the open circuit is the voltage across the A and B terminal. So directly we are going to the problem for open circuit. Find the voltage across the terminals A, B for the circuit shown and below. This is one problem, this is another problem. So here there will not be any current flowing through this circuit, so we are just assuming I is equal to 0. Because of I is equal to 0, the voltage drop across the 120 ohm resistor is also 0, because V is equal to I into R. So the voltage across this 20 ohm resistor is also 0. Now we should find what is the voltage across the terminal A and B. Usually I used to take the KVL like this. So when you are having a negative terminal to the positive terminal and you are traveling in the same current direction, then we are taking this as a voltage rise. And whenever you are passing through any of the resistor, we are consider this as a voltage drop. This is a voltage rise and this is a voltage drop we are assuming. So according to that, KVL 10 minus 120 into 0 minus voltage drop across A and B is VAB equal to 0. Now if you simplify, then you are getting VAB is equal to 10 volt. Similarly for the second problem also, if you just mention that I is equal to 0, then you will be getting the same answer. You can get a question that here it is 20 ohm is mentioned, but in this diagram it is not. Same, if you are having 20 ohm also, there will not be any flow of current. So the voltage drop across this ohm resistor is also 0. So the voltage drop across the terminal AB is equal to 60 ohm. Next is find VAB in the circuit shown. So here also you are going to find what is VAB. Now what do you have to do? The voltage source is here. So first you should find the voltage across the 15 ohm resistor. Then you can find out what is the voltage across this resistor. Okay, because it is parallel with this. This 15 ohm is parallel with this. But here there is 25 kilo ohm. So first we will be drawing the current route. So from here current I is flowing, then it is just separating I want through 15 kilo ohm resistor, and again it is another current is flowing through 25 kilo ohm resistor. So this I1 current is separating here as I1 and I2 here. But if you consider this area, A and B terminal is open, so there will not be any current through 25 kilo ohm resistor. So only we can consider what is I1. If you take I1, which is equal to I, because the total current is flowing through only 10 kilo ohm and 15 kilo ohm. So if you find out what is I or I1, I will be finding both are equal. So you can find what is I. So if you take this circuit, it is a loop. These two are connected in series. So if you want to find out the equivalent resistance, just simply you have to add, because these both are in series connection. So 10 plus 15 is equal to 25 kilo ohm, and the voltage is 50 volt. I is equal to V by R, so 50 divided by 25, and then you have to find what is the voltage across the 15 kilo ohm. Here you should be clear that you have to apply the voltage divider rule, because this voltage divider rule is applied when this source voltage is connected between some series of resistors which is connected to the source voltage. In that case, you can find the individual voltage drop in the particular resistance. Now you want to find the individual voltage drop in the 15 kilo ohm resistor. So voltage drop across the 15 kilo ohm resistor, you have to apply the formula of voltage divider, which is V into 15 kilo ohm divided by total equivalent resistance. So 10 plus 15 is 25. So just you have to apply like this, is equal to 30 ohm. You can apply like voltage divider rule, or you can just simply take VAB is equal to I into R. So R is 15 kilo ohm, I you have find out, so I into 15 kilo ohm. Anyway, you can apply, which is equal to 30 ohm. 30 volt you have find out, which is equal to voltage across the terminal A and B. Next problem, what is the current through the resistor R1 when the switch is opened? Here they have mentioned one switch, and they are asking you to find out the current when this switch is opened. For your understanding, I have created when the switch is closed, and also two diagram I have mentioned for your understanding. When it is opened, this is a diagram. When the switch is closed, this is diagram. When the switch is closed, this current is just diverting, separating as I1 and I2, because this is like current divider. So this I1 and I2 will be separated into two branches. But when this is opened, so this I1 will be flowing through R1 and I2 will be flowing through R2. But this switch is opened, so there will not be any flow of current through R2. So the total current I will be flowing through the resistance R1. So your question is, what is the current through the resistance resistor R1 when the switch is open? So this is the picture for your question. So when it is opened, the current flowing through the R1 resistor is I1, which is equal to I. So your answer will be current through R1 is I only. Also, I have given some three exercise problem. You try it and you can find out the answer. Answer is also mentioned here, and I will solve this problem in next video. Now we are going to short circuit. What is short circuit? If a component is said to be short circuited, which means that path is having zero resistance, which is connected parallel to the source or with the resistance, like it is having the zero resistance. That's what we are going to mention it using the short circuit. So that path is having zero resistance, which is connected parallel with the source voltage, that is called short circuit. According to the current divider rule, now we are going to find out what is the current flowing through this R1, what is the current flowing through this short circuit path. You know the current divider rule. So if you want to find out IR equal to total current I into opposite resistance RSS divided by RSS plus R1. Now you know that will not, the resistance of this short circuit path is zero, which means no resistance. So if you substitute this value, then your IR will be zero, which means there will not be any flow of current in the R1. So the total current will be flowing through this ISS. Here is the derivation for that. So because here there will not be any current, it is zero, so totally this I1 will be I will be flowing through ISS only. So ISS is equal to I. Here is the derivation for that. Same, ISS equal to I into opposite resistance R1 divided by R1 plus RSS. So RSS is 0, so R1 will get cancelled, then I. So you should be very clear in that. There will not be any flow of current through the short circuited component, and all the current is flowing through the short circuit path. And the total resistance of the short circuit path is obviously zero because the current will flow here. So total resistance is zero only, and the voltage is also zero because the resistance value is zero. So obviously the voltage across the short circuit path is zero. So using this concept, we are going to see some problems. Now short circuit the resistance 10 ohm and find the current through the short circuit path. So here is the 10 ohm resistor. You are going to do the short circuit of this 10 ohm resistance and find the current. So just you are doing short circuit. So obviously the current flowing through the 10 ohm resistance is zero. So they are asking you to find the current through this. So what is the current I which is flowing through 20 ohm resistor? That will be the current of this total path. So V equal to IR. So I equal to 30 by 20, 1.5 ampere. Next problem is find the current I when the resistance 20 ohm is short circuited. So here this 20 ohm is short circuited. Okay. Now you have to find out what is the current. You have to find the value of current. If you this current is flowing here, then it is separating into I1 and I2 like this. You have to find what is I1 and what is I2, then you can find what is I by adding I1 and I2. Now just you have to apply only the Ohm's law or KVL anything for this I1 current. If you take this voltage 10 volt I1 means R1 and R2 both are connected in parallel, so the voltage across this 10 ohm also 10 volt, the voltage drop across this 10 ohm also 10 volt. Now if you find out what is I1, I is equal to V by R, so 10 by 10. Similarly here also 10 by 10, so you will be getting I1 as 1 ampere and I2 is 1 ampere. So you want to find what is the total current. So I is equal to adding of these two, you will be getting 2 ampere. Next is find the current I and the voltage across 60 ohm resistor when the switch is open and closed. So you should do two types of problem here. First is open, okay. You have to find what is I and voltage across 60 ohm resistor. So when switch is open, you just neglect this area, you will be having this. So just watch this circuit. Now they are asking you to find the current I. Okay, so just you have to find what is I. Just simply KVL, V is equal to I into R. So 40 is equal to this, all three are in series. Just simply add it, I equal to 40 by this value equal to 0.25 ampere. You have find out what is the current. Then voltage across 60 ohm. So V is equal to I into R. So V equal to I is 0.25 into R is 60 ohm. So if you multiply these two, you will be getting 15 voltage. This is a printing mistake, 15 voltage. And then second question is, which is closed? When it is closed, this will be short circuited. So there current flowing through the 60 ohm resistor is zero. So the current flowing through the short circuit will be equal to 50 ohm and 50 ohm resistor equivalent value. We should find out the equivalent resistance is 50 plus 50. So I equal to 40 divided by 50 plus 50, then 0.4 ampere. So you have find out what is the current flowing in the short circuit. Then you have to find the voltage also. So voltage is equal to V equal to I into R. If you see the current flowing here, it is zero. So the current is zero. Obviously the voltage across the 60 ohm resistor is also zero. When the circuit is closed, it is open, then it will be 15 ohm. Next problem is, find the equivalent resistance between the terminal A, B. So you have to find the equivalent resistance between A and B. So if you think about the circuit, this area don't have any effect, because here you have one short circuit in between this total area. So the equivalent resistance between A and B is only this 15 ohm, which is having the short circuit path. So the equivalent resistance of this network between A and B is 15 ohm only. This is your answer. Similarly, same for this circuit, find the equivalent resistance. Here also you are having this 25 kilo ohm, 10 kilo ohm. So the current flowing through this two resistors is zero. Similarly here also, so the current will flow through here, this short circuit. So the equivalent resistance of this AB terminal is zero. Very easy. So hope you understand what is open circuit and what is short circuit and all. We should know what is open circuit and short circuit, because in future we are going to see about so many theorems like superposition theorem, Norton theorem, maximum power transfer theorem, etc. So that time you need to know about this open circuit, short circuit and all. Then only it will be easy to find out the theorems that time. So we will meet in next video. Thank you.